We've talked about MRR before, monthly recurring revenue, and we know it's defined as a measure and a representation of the monthly value of the recurring elements of your contracts. But how do you calculate MRR? I'm glad you asked. A PowerPoint presentation with simple formulas can lead you to believe that MRR calculations are very easy and simple. And in some cases, they are. See? Easy. The exceptions are what can really cause issues. The higher the value of your contract elements and the more sales negotiation and contract volatility you have, the more difficult it can be to define the rules. In B2B SaaS, sales negotiations and exceptions pop up far more often than not, so we use the following more accurate formula. MRR equals your recurring contract element amounts times 365 divided by 12 divided by the number of days between the contract start date and the contract end date plus 1 day. This exact days formula allows us to account for contract elements where the number of days does not fall within the range of a predefined MRR tolerance. And this allows us to accommodate for common exceptions like mid-month start dates, contract gaps, and early renewal upgrades. One last thing that's important to note, you should only include recurring contract elements in your ARR or your MRR calculations. Otherwise, it can lead to a lot of headache and heartache and overhead, and we'll cover that in much more detail in another ACA video. So there you have it, beauties. That's how you calculate MRR. We'll see you next time for the next Ask Claytone Anything.